conference. So my name is Daniel Volk from the University of Central Florida, and I'm finishing up my master's thesis looking at demographic and evolutionary history in coral reef gobies and the genus Corypopterus. So first, populations in the marine realm were thought to be connected over vast geographic distances, but we now know that there are actually many biogeographic barriers in marine phylogeography that separate these populations. So looking within the Western Atlantic, there are actually several biogeographic barriers, with the largest one being the combined outflow of the Amazon and Orinoco rivers. Together, they let out approximately 300,000 cubic meters of fresh water every second. This immense plume of fresh water and sediment is known to inhibit gene flow between the Brazilian and Caribbean provinces. A slightly lesser known barrier are these isolated oceanic islands off the coast of Brazil here, which are known to harbor several endemic species. And so I've decided to use the Corypopterus glaucophrenum species complex as my model system, because it spans both of these biogeographic barriers and also has limited dispersal potential. And the reason for this is that coral reef fish are known to be largely sedentary as adults and do most of their dispersing as larvae, in addition to them being very small, so very low dispersal potential there. And in contrast to pelagic spawning taxa that broadcast spawn, these are demersal spawning taxa, which means that they lay their eggs directly on substrate and are presumably less influenced by ocean current or passive dispersal. And so these two traits together, or these several traits combined, suggest that they have limited dispersal potential, which means that they may be largely impacted by these oceanographic barriers. And some previous work on this taxon had all three of these morphs as one species that was widely distributed. However, using both the morphological and genetic data, they have been defined as three distinct species, but they all co-occur in the Caribbean. However, the only one that branches down further to Brazil is Corypopterus glaucophrenum. But because most of the work has been done exclusively in the Caribbean, it has left the Brazilian populations to be entirely uncharacterized, which leads me to my first question, which is to see if Brazilian populations are genetically distinct from Caribbean populations. And then my second question that I'll look at is, within each lineage, which minor barriers inhibit gene flow in each province? So I first collected 176 samples of glaucophrenum and 39 of Venezuelan, that is throughout both of their ranges. I used Tortugae as my outgroup, using about a 550 base pair region of the CO1 gene. I first created a phylogeny in BEAST, and then I also calculated percent sequence divergence using the Camerata 2 parameter. And what we found from this is that, in fact, there are, within our clade of interest, there are actually four lineages here. The first one is the glaucophrenum lineage that is exclusive to the Caribbean and occurs in sympatry with Venezuela. However, across the Amazon barrier here, we have a coastal lineage of Brazil and also these oceanic islands, the Rocas Atoll, are isolated as well, leading to four distinct lineages that are well supported. And then looking at the sequence divergence within taxa is not very much, but between taxa ranges from 6 to 12% here, which is comparable to species level divergence in this genus. And so what we found from this is that Corypopterus glaucophrenum is not monophyletic and does indeed comprise multiple clades that are split by not only the Amazon barrier, but also the isolated oceanic islands. And I'm waiting for some morphological description from some colleagues after listening to the species delimitation debates, which was very intriguing. And so I'd like to wait to definitively describe these as new species. For my second question, I was interested in minor barriers within each lineage. And so first focusing on the Caribbean region, there are several common biogeographic barriers that have been defined largely from ocean currents, although they are seen with empirical data also, but they often vary in their effectiveness within each taxon, and then also they vary in their precise location because ocean currents are known to fluctuate on a pretty large scale. Additionally, in the Cabo Frio region of Brazil here, there's a significant ecological nutrient and cold water upwelling system here, which is known to inhibit gene flow between demersal spawning taxa across this barrier. And so what I've done is subset my samples into their lineages that I found, first looking at Venezuela up in the Caribbean, and then followed by the Caribbean Vacafrana lineage, and lastly the Brazilian Vacafrana lineage. Using the same sequence data set, I first calculated for isolation by distance, looking at pairwise bias T between populations, and also the oceanic distance between populations. And then I calculated, I performed a haplotype network analysis in order to look at the distribution of haplotypes in each population. So starting with Venezuela, there was populations range from about 200 to 2400 kilometers. And as is typical for many marine taxa, they showed no trend of isolation by distance. But when looking at the haplotype network, we see that focusing on Venezuela here in orange, that it is significantly isolated from the rest of the Caribbean. In fact, it shares no haplotypes with any of the other Caribbean populations. It is consistently at least two locations away from any of the other Caribbean populations. And when looking at the specific pairwise genetic divergence between populations, it did show a strong trend of isolation. Looking at the Caribbean Vacafrana lineage, populations range from 200 to 2,500 kilometers, and again show no pattern of isolation by distance. And looking at the haplotype network, and again focusing on Venezuela, it showed minimal isolation here from the rest of the Caribbean, and did actually share one of the haplotypes with the most common haplotype here. And it was only a few mutations away from that common haplotype, which is similar to all these other populations. However, when looking at the pairwise genetic differentiation, it did show some slight isolation there. And then looking at the overall shape of the network here, there's one common haplotype that almost all the populations share, followed by many haplotypes that are rare and are only a few mutations away. And this generally suggests that this is an expanding lineage here. Looking at the Brazilian Vacafrana plate, populations range from about 300 to 3,500 kilometers and did show a significant pattern of isolation by distance. And so to see if barriers were impacting the system here, I looked at the pairwise bias T between populations, and the only ones that were significant were the ones between northern and southern populations across that Cabo Frio barrier. And so essentially what that means is that exchanged gene flow freely, and southern populations exchanged gene flow freely, but across that barrier there was something that was limited to the source control. And looking at the general shape of this network again, we see that the expansion is potentially here in this lineage. And then focusing more specifically on from north to south here, the two southernmost populations in Rio de Janeiro and Santa Catarina showed very low genetic diversity. In fact, if you count two haplotypes and 1, 2, 3 haplotypes for these populations respectively, they're very low in diversity relative to the others here. And in fact, we tested for nucleotide diversity between northern and southern populations, and it was significantly reduced in southern populations. And this potentially suggests that there was a recent founder event that occurred across that Cabo Frio barrier. And so to sum up, what we've found so far is that there are multiple lineages potentially indicative of species level divergence. However, again, I'd like to wait on that morphological data set to come in to confirm this. And then there was a concordant isolation of Venezuela, although the Vacafrana lineage showed a much weaker trend of isolation, whereas the Venezuelan lineage was relatively strong for that Venezuelan isolation. And so specifically looking at the variation in these barriers, the east-west barrier, which is typically drawn here from Cohen et al., has been shown to fluctuate slightly. So using both empirical and oceanographic modeling, Foster et al. Showed that it was slightly shifted eastward. But in this present study, I'm suggesting that in this taxon, it was even more so shifted east. And the reason for this is that I had two populations, Curacao and Venezuela, that were only 200 kilometers apart, but were genetically distinct from one another. And in fact, the Curacao population grouped with the rest of the Caribbean here, which suggests that there was no presence of any other barriers in this system. And looking at the overall demography here, we saw that both the Caribbean and Brazilian lineages seem to be expanding. And in fact, we saw that the northern Brazil populations had much more diversity than southern Brazil, potentially indicating a recent founder event across that Cabo Frio barrier. And while I used only one gene for this data set, and we're all interested in moving to the genomic era, I do have a genomic data set that is coming in, although this one gene was useful as a pilot study to see if it's worthwhile to keep going. And so, in fact, I have a genomic data set that should be coming in this week from NextGrad, from SNPsource down here, using a very small amount of DNA, so it's really helpful. What I'd like to do is go through approximate Bayesian computation to look to model dispersal events and patterns and see the divergence time of these lineages. And with that, I'd like to thank my lab mates in the Hoffman lab here, my Brazilian collaborators and Smithsonian collaborators, Phase Lab, who is a combined lab group of ours, all of our funding sources. And with that, I think I have a minute or two for questions.
Nice talk. Would you say the group originated in the Caribbean?
Yeah, so the entirety of the genus, basically, there's about 13 species, all of which occur in the Caribbean. And so that's one of the things that I want to test with my ABC analysis is presuming that they originated in the Caribbean and dispersed out towards Brazil. So I want to use the ABC analysis to figure out if that's the case.